In a faraway land, a young prince lived in a shining castle. Although he had everything his heart desired, the prince was spoiled, selfish, and unkind. But then, one winter's night, an old beggar woman came to the castle and offered him a single rose in return for shelter from the bitter cold. Repulsed by her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at the gift and turned the old woman away. But she warned him not to be deceived by appearances, for beauty is found within. And when he dismissed her again, the old woman's ugliness melted away to reveal a beautiful enchantress. The prince tried to apologize, but it was too late, for she had seen that there was no love in his heart. As punishment, she transformed him into a hideous beast, placed a powerful spell on the castle and all who lived there. Ashamed of his monstrous form, the beast concealed himself inside his castle with a magic mirror. This is only window to the outside world. The rose she had offered was truly an enchanted rose, which would bloom for many years. If he could learn to love another and earn their love in return by the time the last petal fell, then the spell would be broken. If not, he would be doomed to remain a beast for all time. As the years passed, he fell into despair and lost all hope, for who could ever learn to love a beast?
Thank you. And I've got my sights set on that one.
The inventor's daughter.
She's the lucky girl I'm going to marry.
But she's...
the most beautiful girl in town.
I know, but...
don't I deserve the best?
Of course you do.
Right from the moment when I met her, saw her, I said she's gorgeous and I fell. Here in town there's only she who is beautiful as me. So I'm making plans to go and marry now.
But there he goes, isn't he dreamy? Oscar, Gaston, oh he's so cute! He's still my heart, I heard the dream. He's such a tall, dark, strong, and handsome.
Martha! Excuse me, please let me through. More important things.
Hint, hint. Like you?
Exactly. The whole town's talking about it. It isn't right for a woman to read. Soon she starts getting ideas and thinking.
Gaston, you are positively prime evil.
Well, thank you, Belle. Now, what do you say, me and you, take a walk down to my tavern and take a look at my trophies?
What do you say we don't?
Come on, Belle, I think I know how you feel about me.
You can't possibly imagine. Gaston, please, I have to get inside to help my father.
That crazy old fool? Ha! He needs all the help he can get!
Don't talk about my father that way.
Yeah, don't talk about her father that way.
My father's not crazy, he's a genius.
I'm never going to get this boneheaded contraption to work right.
Yes, you will, and you'll win first prize at the fair tomorrow.
Well, it's not going to fix itself, so we better get cracking. If I could only... let's see, where's that dog-legged clip?
Papa.
Oh, thank you, Val. So, did you have a good time in town today?
Well, I got a new book.
Oh, you do love those books.
Papa, do you think I'm odd?
My daughter? Odd? Now, why would you think a thing like that?
I don't know. It's just that people talk.
They talk about me, too. No, we're not odd, it's true. No family could be saner, except one uncle who, well, maybe let that pass. No, you say or do, you couldn't make it plainer. You are your mother's daughter, therefore you are class.
So I should just accept I'm simply not like them.
They are the common herd, but you can take my word. By your side, and if my point of view is somewhat misty-eyed, death and clearer in my life than what I wish and feel for you. And that's a lot, no matter what.
Really, sir?
This is real!
Oh.
just have never seen a time.
Oh, monsieur, you're chilled to the bone. Come, warm yourself by the fire.
Not the master's chair. I'm not seeing this. I'm not seeing this.
Oh la la. What do we have here? Do my eyes deceive me? Or is this a real man?
Hello there.
All right. This has gone far enough.
Tommy?
How would you like a nice pot of tea, sir? It'll warm you up in no time.
Oh, well, thank you. I'd love some. I'm so...
Whoa! I think I scared him, Mama.
Well, hello there, little one. What's your name?
Shit!
Careful, blanket, monsieur.
Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you.
That's enough. That is enough. Do you have any idea what the master will do if he finds out we let a stranger in?
Oh, calm yourself, Cogsworth. The master will never know.
There's a stranger here.
Oh, master, allow me to explain.
Who let him in?
No, master. May I take this opportunity to say I was against it from the start.
You have all betrayed me.
Yeah?
Who are you? What are you doing in my castle?
I'm sorry. I was lost, and I was looking.
You are not welcome here.
No, okay, I'll just be on my way. No.
It's hideous, isn't it? You come to stare at the beast, haven't you?
No, I meant no harm. I'm sorry. I was just looking for a place to stay.
I'll give you a place to stay.
No.
Surprises for you, mademoiselle.
A miniature portrait of yourself. You shouldn't have.
Don't mention it. You know, Belle, there isn't a girl in town who wouldn't love to be in your shoes. This is the day I make your dreams come true.
What could you possibly know about my dreams, Gaston?
Plenty!
One dream, nearly all your life. Been scheming just one theme. Will you be a wife? Will you be some demon's property? Good news that he lands me. This equation, nil plus man, doesn't help just you.
A rustic hunting lodge. My latest kill roasting on the fire. My little wife massaging my feet while the little ones play on the floor with the dogs. Who have six or seven?
Dogs?
No, Belle. Strapping boys like me.
Imagine that.
I can see that we will share all that love implies. best things in life are all's well that ends with me. Will it be? Is it yes? Or is it? Oh, yeah!
I just don't deserve you.
Who does? Playing hard to get.
She turned you down?
For now. But I will have Belle for my wife. Make no mistake about that.
If she turned him down, maybe now I have a chance. Wait for me, Gaston. No, me. Is he gone? Can you imagine? Me, the wife of that boorish, brainless
with us for quite some time. Perhaps you might want to offer her a more how shall I say, a comfortable room.
I'll show you to your room.
What?
You follow me! This is your home now. You're free to go anywhere you like except the West Wing.
Why? What's in the West Wing?
It's forbidden! You are never to set foot there, do you understand?
Yes.
This is your room. If you need anything, my servants will attend you. And one more thing. You will join me for dinner. That is not a request!
Through. I hope that we'll be friends, though I don't
Colonel Gaston. Dismissed, rejected, publicly humiliated. It's more than I can bear.
I'm here.
Oh, LeFou, I'm disgraced.
Will you never, Gaston? You've got to pull yourself together.
Gosh, it disturbs me to see Gaston looking so down in the dumps. Every guy should like to meet you, Gaston, even when taking your lumps. There's no man in town as admired as you. You're everyone's favorite guy.
Everyone wanted inspired by you. And it's not very hard to see why.
No one's slick as Gaston. No one's quick as Gaston. No one's next as incredibly thick as Gaston.
Dangerous pastime.
I know, but that wacky old kook just spells father.
It's time for dinner. Where is she?
I'll go check on her. Won't be a minute.
Try to be patient, sir. The girl has lost her father and her freedom only one day.
Oh, Master, have you given any thought to perhaps that this girl maybe is the one to break the spell?
Of course I have. I'm not a fool.
Oh, wonderful. You fall in love with her, she falls in love with you. Poof, the spell's broken. We are human again by midnight.
It's not that easy, Lumiere. These things take time.
Oh, but we have no time. The rose has already begun to wilt.
It's no use. She's so beautiful and I'm... Well, look at me.
Master, you must help us see Pastel.
I don't know how.
Well, you could start by making yourself more, presentable.
Impress her with your rapier wit.
No, but be gentle.
Shower her with compliments.
But be sincere. And above all...
What?
You must control your temper.
Well, where is she?
She's not coming.
What did you say?
She's not coming.
We'll see about that.
Your lordship, your grace, your eminence, let's not be hasty.
I thought I told you to come to dinner.
I'm not hungry.
I am the master of this castle, and I am telling you to come to dinner.
Oh, Master, that may not be the best way to win the girl's affections.
Please, attempt to be a gentleman.
Deep breath, Master. Deep breath.
I'll give her one last chance. Would you be so kind as to join me for dinner? Please!
No, thank you.
Fine, then starve!
Oh, Master, please!
She doesn't eat with me. She doesn't eat at all!
Oh, what are we thinking? We will never be human again!
What would you have us do? Give up? I like this girl. I like her spunk.
If you ask me, she was just being stubborn. After all, the master did say please.
I do believe that is the first time I've ever heard him use that word. Oh, hello, dearie. I hope the master didn't frighten you too much. He can be a bit temperamental.
A bit? I am Cotsworth, head of the household, and this is Lumiere.
Ah! Enchanté, mademoiselle.
If there is anything we can do to make your stay more comfortable, anything, anything at all.
Well, actually, I am a little hungry.
Except that...
Coxswain.
Well, you heard what the master said.
Oh, patient Tosh. I'm not about to let the poor child go hungry.
Fine. Glass of water, crust of bread...
Oh, Coxswain! She's not a prisoner, she's our guest. We must make her feel welcome here.
All right. Dinner. Mm-hmm. But keep it down. If the master finds out, it'll be our necks.
Of course, of course. But what is dinner without a little music?
Music?
Ma chère mademoiselle, it is with deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we welcome you here tonight. Now, we invite you to relax. Your dinner. Be our guest, be our guest. Put our service to the test. Tie your napkin around your neck, sherry, and we provide service. Soup de jour, hors d'oeuvre, why we only make to serve. Try the grey stuff.
It's delicious. What?
Don't believe me, ask the dishes. They can sing, they can dance. After all, this is France. And the dinner here is never second best. Come on, unfold your menu. Take a glance and then you be our guest. We are guests, be our guests.
We crack you, cheese souffle, pie and pudding au gourmet.
We prepare and serve with flair a culinary cabaret. Complaining while the flatterers entertaining.
We tell jokes.
I do tricks.
late. Off to your cupboards now.
Oh, Lumiere, thank you for dinner. It was delicious.
Oh, my goodness. Look at the time. Off to bed.
Oh, I couldn't possibly go to bed now. It's my first time in an enchanted castle.
Perhaps you'd like a tour.
I'm not sure that's such a good idea.
Perhaps you could give me the tour? I'm sure you know everything there is to know about the castle.
Well, actually, I do. Right this way, mademoiselle.
Okay, I can do this. Act like a gentleman. Act like a gentle man. This'll be good.
And that is yet another example of the late neoclassic Baroque period. And as I always say, if it's not Baroque, don't fix it. may I draw your attention to the flying buttresses above the aviary?
Oh, Lumiere, it's all so beautiful. I had no idea. If only he weren't here.
Act like a gentleman. I'm nothing but a fool.
And thanks to some quick thinking on my part, the disaster was averted.
What's over there?
Nothing! Nothing of any interest in the West Wing.
Oh, so that's the West Wing.
Nice going!
I wonder what he's hiding there.
Perhaps mademoiselle would like to see something else? Over here, we have exquisite tapestries dating all the way back.
Thinking I Riverside. Well, you shouldn't have been in the West Wing.
And you should learn to control your temper. Now, hold still. This may sting a little. By the way, thank you for saving my life.
You're welcome.
That's more like it. I knew they could get along if they only tried.
Oh, so the ice is broken at last.
Not a moment too soon either. The rose is losing petals at an alarming rate.
And I can hardly bend over it all anymore.
Clearly, it's time for us to give them a little push.
I have just the thing. How about we warm you two up a bit with a nice bowl of soup? There's something sweet and almost kind. He was mean and he was coarse and unrefined. But now he's dear and so unsure. I wonder why I didn't see him there before.
Arthur drew forth the sword.
So that must mean he's the king!
wait and see.
I never knew books could do that.
Do what?
Take me away from this place. Make me forget for a little while.
Forget?
Who I... what I am.
We have something in common, you know?
What?
In the town where I come from, the people there, they think I'm odd.
You?
So, I know what it feels like to be different. I know how lonely that can be. For the third time, Arthur drew forth the sword, and there arose from a crowd a great cheer. Arthur was king.
Told you so.
They're still in there.
Yes, he is behaving like a perfect gentleman.
Mama, I have a funny feeling inside. I don't know what it is, but it makes me feel all bubbly.
Yes, oh, little one. I'm beginning to feel it too.
We, my little friend, the day we've been waiting for is finally at hand.
If only that were true, Lumiere.
Oh, human again.
Human again.
Think what that means. I'll be quirking again, be good looking again, with a mademoiselle on each arm. When I'm human again, only human again, poised and polished and gleaming with charm. I'll be courting again, chic and sporting again,
which should cause several husbands alarm.
I'll hop down off the shelf,
swinging myself.
I can't wait to be human again.
When we're human again.
She stole away to a convent, and no one could ever make her smile again. That's the end.
What a beautiful story.
I knew you'd like it. I'd like to ask you for something.
What's that?
A second chance? Dinner with me tonight?
Dinner? Me? With you? Why that be? I mean, oh yes!
It's like this, see? Tonight is the night you confess your love, my prince.
I really don't think I can do that.
You must.
But how will I know when the moment is right?
Oh, you will feel it in here. And remember, you must speak from the heart.
I must speak from the... I can't!
You must! What are you afraid of?
I'm afraid she might...
She might what?
Laugh at me.
Somehow, my prince, you must find the courage to take the chance.
Master, look at the rose. There's so little time left.
I really don't think I can do this.
I know you can, Master. You must!
Something wrong.
I was just thinking about my papa. I miss him so much. I just wish I could see him one more time.
There is a way. This mirror will show you anything. Anything you wish to see.
I'd like to see my father, please. Oh, no. Oh, Papa. He's in the woods. I think he's lost.
You should go to him.
What?
You should go to him.
But what about...
You're not my prisoner, Belle. You haven't been for a long while now. But take the mirror with you so you'll have a way to look back and remember me.
I could never forget you.
Belle, I...
Yes?
Go. Go! I'll never see her again.
Well, sire, I must say, everything is going just swimmingly. I knew you had it in you.
I let her go.
You what?
How could you do that?
I had to.
But why?
He's finally learned to love after all this time.
Well, that's it then. That should break the spell.
Yeah, it's not that easy. She must love him in return.
And now, it's far too late.
Mm-hmm.
I thought I'd never find you.
Oh, wait, the beast. How did you escape?
I didn't escape. He let me go.
He let you go? That terrible beast?
He's not terrible. In the beginning, I thought it was the end of everything, but somehow, things changed.
How?
There's been a change in me, a kind of moving on.
Misunderstanding if...
If what?
If you'll marry me.
What?
One little word, Belle. That's all it takes.
Never.
Have it your way. Take the old man.
Wait. I can prove my father's not crazy. Show me the beast.
That's him.
Is he dangerous?
Oh, no. I know he looks frightful, but he's really kind and gentle. He's my friend.
If I had known any better, I'd say you have feelings for this monster.
He's not the monster, Gaston. You are.
She's as crazy as the old man. She says this creature is her friend. Well, I've hunted wild beasts, and I've seen what they can do. The beast will make off with your children. He'll come after them in the night.
He would never do that.
Forget the old man. I say we kill the beast.
Kill him!
He'll wreak havoc on our city if we let him wander free.
darkness and the shadows. It's a nightmare, but it's one exciting ride. Say a prayer that we're there at the drawbridge of a castle, and there's something truly terrible inside.
It's a beast, he's got fangs, razor sharp ones. That's a claws, killer claws, one of the beasts.
Hear him roar, see him foam,
but we're not coming home.
Papa, it's not my fault. I have to go and warn him.
I'm going with you.
No.
I've lost you once. I'm not going to lose you again.
Who rid the village of this beast? Who's with me?
I am.
Hearts ablaze, banners high. We'll go marching into battle. I'm afraid all of the dangers as a dream. Raise the flag, sing the song. Here we come, 150 strong and 50 Frenchmen.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, follow me.
Ooh, la, la, la.
Darling, of course. Do I still have to sleep in the cupboard?